Let's learn how to use Google Notebook LM even as a beginner. And because we're going to start thinking smarter and not harder, we're going to go to the source. We're going to use Google's 8 expert tips for getting started with Notebook LM. This comes from the main guy behind Google Notebook LM, Stephen Johnson, author of 14 books. And based on this article, a Googler who has worked on the Notebook LM team from the beginning of the project 2 years ago. But before we learn how to use it and what his 8 steps for using Google Notebook LM are, let's learn what he says Google Notebook LM is. Simply put, Google Notebook LM is a tool for understanding things. Think of it as your virtual note-taking and research assistant. Notebook LM takes information, analyzes it, digests it, so that you can glean more from it. It's designed for that deeper dive that you may need to take into a topic or multiple topics at once. With Notebook LM, you create individual notebooks dedicated to a topic or project. You can upload up to 50 sources with up to 25 million words. Incredible. All from things like PDFs, Google Docs, websites, and YouTube videos. You can ask questions about the content or ask Notebook LM to format it in a specific way. It will even provide citations that link back to the most relevant original passages in your sources. And along the way, your private information is never shared or used to train the model, which is so important, especially if you are a business owner. Number one, experiment with your recent documents, even if they're random. One of the first things Stephen suggests new Notebook LM users do is upload their 10 most recent documents into one notebook and start experimenting by asking questions. It's a great way to test run what Notebook LM can do. So let's actually do this right now, and I'm going to do it with you. You'll go to notebooklm.google, and this screen will pop up. You will click Try Notebook LM. You will be taken to a new screen, click New Notebook. This is where you will add your 10 most recent documents. So you can see here that I have my 10 most recent documents, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Within the first tip, Stephen recommends we start experimenting by asking questions. We'll click the notebook. You're going to click that. Once that pops up, here in the middle, we could start to ask questions. What are 3 patterns that will help entrepreneurs make money? It says monetizing expertise through content creation, building a strong personal brand, leveraging LinkedIn newsletters. And I'm just going to call this like brain dump random. Step 2 is create one main notebook and then identify topic-based notebooks from there. I've got a notebook devoted exclusively to the work we do building Notebook LM. It's got all the press releases, new feature descriptions, and important internal docs we write as a team. By keeping all those related resources in a single notebook, Stephen effectively has a personalized AI that's almost like having another member of the team. I can type something like, draft the outline of a blog post for that feature we were discussing last week. For the purposes of this video, I've created a notebook called LinkedIn Newsletter Mastery. I've connected 13 of my YouTube videos. If you're not subscribed, you should totally subscribe. How many characters can a LinkedIn newsletter title be again? A LinkedIn newsletter can be 30 characters or less. That is true. I could save this note if there's ever a team member that could potentially have that question. I could also say, what was that one formula to create a newsletter title? The formula is result plus person equals your LinkedIn newsletter. This is true. Okay, yeah, this is great. And I could save the note. The way that I would save the note is I would click the little pin. And then as you could see, it says new note saved. Number 3, use Notebook LM to connect the dots from different materials. We all have this problem where we're working on something and the information we need is gathered across desktop folders, tabs, and whatever else. This is what Notebook LM is made for, connecting all those scattered dots. Stephen offers the example of working on a slide deck. Maybe you start the process by brainstorming with Gemini, which leads you to open a few tabs of articles, save some design inspo images, and put some notes in a Google Doc. You can then feed all of that into Notebook LM so that you could reference everything in one place when you get to the stage of building your presentation in Google Slides. Let's do something like that. We're going to go to Google Gemini, and I'm going to ask it What are 7 ways to monetize the audio overview podcast from Google Notebook LM? Direct listener support, Patreon, sponsorships, offer ad slots. Can you direct me to some sources on how to implement these strategies? Perfect. So what I could do is I could copy this. I could go to Google Notebook LM. I could click Try Notebook, New Notebook. I could paste this information. I could title it up here as How to Monetize Audio Podcasts. And then I could add the different sources that Gemini gave me. I'm going to click the website and paste. We have 2 websites and pasted text. I could also add a Google Doc documents, and I'll click ideas to monetize audio podcasts. And what I'm doing is I'm putting all of this stuff together so that I could then understand what the best ideas are to monetize the podcast. Number 4, start with the suggested questions. Once you've added content to Notebook LM, it's time to start asking questions. Steven says Notebook LM suggested questions are a great source. We're going to go back to the LinkedIn newsletter mastery. We're going to go to the notebook guide. This one's good. What are the key benefits of using a LinkedIn newsletter compared to traditional marketing? Let's see the output. This is true. Higher open rates, true. Leveraging existing network, true. Segmentation, very true. Thought leadership, very true. SEO, very true. Save to note. And then I could rename these notes. Benefits of LinkedIn newsletters. Perfect. Number 5, ask Notebook LM to deliver info in different ways. Using the Notebook Guide feature, Notebook LM can turn your uploaded content into an FAQ, briefing document, timeline, table of contents, study guide, or the popular new audio overview. Try different options to see what works best for your own learning purposes as well as for presenting information to others. So to do that, go back to where your notebook is. We're going to go back to LinkedIn Newsletter Mastery. You're going to enter your notebook, click notebook guide at the bottom right. Once you do that, you'll see FAQ, study guide, table of contents, timeline, briefing doc. And then you'll also see deep dive conversation. Let's start with the FAQ. When you click something like the FAQ sheet, you'll see that a new note starts to generate and it will automatically save the auto response. Remember, the main benefit of this is that it's generating this content from your sources and only your sources. I can confirm this by looking at the questions that it proposes and the answers. I always start and share with my audience, define your one goal. So what is the one goal? Who is the one person? What is the one result you help that person achieve? It pulls from the formula that I've shared before. And this is what I really love about it, is that it's pulling from my source, my IP. This is what makes us unique, and it's creating content from that. Let's try a study guide. LinkedIn Newsletter Mastery, a comprehensive study guide. Quiz tester knowledge. What is the key difference between LinkedIn newsletter and regular LinkedIn posts? I love that. It comes up with the questions. The answer key, it references what it's starting to call my one method, essay question glossary of key terms. I love it. And then this could be LinkedIn quiz. And just think about the use cases for this. If you have courses, I could go live and just start answering these questions because they're really relevant. I could play a quiz game with my audience in a LinkedIn audio room. There's a lot that can be done. The next one is table of contents, a timeline, and I think a great use case, especially for using this as a workspace for a team, is briefing doc. Here is the table of contents. It is following my material. And then here's the briefing doc, and this is great. I could see this becoming like an executive summary. I love that it has the quotes. These are my quotes. They're not some made up quotes. This is great. And then I got this response for the timeline. Please provide the text from the sources Okay, so this is more for like creative writing material. We're not going to get into that. Step 6, don't shy away from creative uses. Notebook LM is an amazing source for work and school projects, but it's also a great tool for creative uses outside the office or classroom. We're seeing a lot of people using it for assistance with writing fantasy and sci-fi novels. Steven particularly likes that you can ask Notebook LM for creative input with questions like, which characters do you think are most compelling? It's like being able to control F for interestingness. For this example, I'm going to LinkedIn Mastery, and I'm going to say, if you had to create a superhero for LinkedIn newsletters, what would it be called? Given the information, the Network Navigator emerges as a fitting name for a superhero. That's boring. Can you create some new names? The Insight Oracle, the Knowledge Weaver, the Inbox Infiltrator. Write a story about the Inbox Infiltrator. The city was drowning in a sea of digital noise. Every day, millions of emails flooded inboxes, most vanishing beneath a tide of promotions, spam, and forgotten newsletters. But unseen in this maelstrom, a lone figure fought to ensure valuable information reached its destination, the Inbox Infiltrator. Her quest led her to the power of LinkedIn newsletters. That is so funny. It definitely can do some creative stuff. Now for number 7, turn your sources into audio overviews. You should definitely turn each of these 10 documents you start with or whatever else you upload into an audio overview. After waiting a few minutes for it to generate, you will have a very entertaining, mind-blowing audio conversation about whatever you uploaded. What we'll do here is we'll generate an audio overview. This is the feature that made Google Notebook LM go viral. You could even give the AI co-host some direction in the conversation that's generated.
Direct listeners to yougrow.club to join our email list. Focus on how this is relevant in 2025.
Generate. Even though it may take a few minutes for the audio overview to be generated, once it's done, you will see it right here. Now let's listen.
Hey everyone, and welcome to another deep dive. Today we're going to be talking about LinkedIn newsletters and whether they're just another fleeting trend or something that business owners like you should be thinking about as we head into 2025. To help us figure this out, we've got some great insights from Shanee Moret.
Shanee is the founder.
Now remember, I told it to focus on 2025. I wrote my name in a way where it would pronounce my name correctly, and both of those things have been achieved already.
Of Growth Academy Global.
And she's got almost 1 million followers on LinkedIn.
So it also added the context of me almost having 1 million followers on LinkedIn, which it should already know from the sources, but I just wanted to give it a little bit more direction.
She clearly knows a thing or two about making the platform work for you.
This is really good so far. And what I could do is I could download, I could change the playback speed. If I don't like it, I could click delete. I could ask it to regenerate another one with a different direction. Number 8, revisit your Notebook LM chat sessions. Let's say you have a conversation about one of your notebooks. You ask a question and then follow up questions, and you even ask it to refine your idea. You don't want to lose whatever progress you made or insights you gathered during that dialogue. At the end of the chat, you could ask Notebook LM to summarize the key points from the conversation into a single note that goes in that notebook. Future you will thank past you and Notebook LM for making it as easy as possible to pick up where you left off. This is what that would look like. As you can see here, I have 3 questions. I have a question and then an answer, a question and then an answer, a question and then an answer. What he says, instead of just leaving and then losing a lot of this progress, especially if I'm trying to make it into one cohesive thought, I could say something like, summarize the past 3 replies into one note so that the next time that I hop in here, the chat isn't lost. How to create a LinkedIn newsletter, the benefits, and then the drawbacks all in one note, save to notes, and then I would not lose that. By the way, thanks again to Google for commenting on our other video.